Hello everyone, good morning and good evening. Let us continue the Python with Django series. Okay. So what I have discussed in the last session, we have gone through the introduction about this Python. Next, we have completed the Python framework setup and the IDE setup. Okay. So let us quickly go through the yesterday session. So the Python was introduced in the year of 1991. Okay. So basically it was developed in the year of 1989, but because it was developed, so it was come to the different phases while released to the outside of the world. Okay. Next, which platforms were using the Python? Many platforms nowadays. Okay. So web applications we are using, web APIs we are using, automation testing, gaming, artificial intelligence, machine learning, data science, networking applications. In different areas, we are using the Python. Okay. So our target is to learn a web application development. So if I want to develop an application, there is a two types nowadays. Either if you want to develop web application or web API. If I want to develop any web application, I need to use Python with Django. So this Django was introduced in the year of 2005. So if I want to develop web API, I need to use Python with Flask. It was introduced in the year of 2010. So ultimately, which is the data storage? Database is the data storage. Okay. So next, we have discussed about a few other things. So next, what a Python contains. If you take a Python programming language, a Python contains the statements. These statements are nothing but simple instructions. That's it. You take any programming language is an instruction for the machine. Which machine you are using? Computer is your machine. Okay, as per your instruction, computer executing the program and getting the output. That's it. If I use the web application, web browser will execute your web application. It will display some data. Okay, so here you are having the comments. Next, data types, functions, conditional statements, looping statements, operators, and keywords. So next we have discussed about the installation. So still anyone facing the installation issues? Hope everybody is good. Okay. If you are not yet installed, so please go through the yesterday's video. Hope already we shared. Okay. Install this Python. Here we are having the steps. While installing the Pythons, we have seen about the three things. What are those? We have discussed about the three things. The first one is the Python framework. The first one, Python framework. Next one is the runtime environment. Next one is the IDE. So what are these three? For example, if you want to develop any application faster, you require that framework. So Python is the framework used to develop an applications. So the purpose of the framework is used to develop applications, used to write a programming. Okay, framework will be provide that one. Either .NET framework we are using to develop an applications. So where have the different types of applications? Web applications or Windows application, whatever it is. Framework will provide the code. It will give you the some programming language. Framework will provide you the code. Programming language. So Python framework providing which programming language? Python is the framework. Python is the programming. If you take a .NET, .NET is a framework which using the C sharp is the language. Okay. So sometimes if you are using the Java, Java is the language. But a few technologies have in a different language as the different from the name. Okay. Python programming language. If I take a .NET, C sharp like this. Next, runtime environment. So framework is providing the code to you. You will write a code. You will develop an application. So, but if you want to compile or not, yes. So runtime environment is used to compile and run application. So instead of going the very big way definitions, let us go simple. That's it. So runtime environment, it will be compile and run your application. Okay. So I will show you again that runtime environment if you are confused. Okay. Next, IDE. What is mean by IDE? So now tell me what is mean by full form of IDE.
Integrated development environment.
Correct. Integrated development environment. Why we are using the IDE? IDE helps to build your code. Nothing but write your code. Are you clear? Three things. Okay. So any one of these three things is not there, it is the headache to develop. For example, IDE is not there. Can I develop? So IDE is not there. How you are going to be developed? Using the command prompt. Okay. So using the command prompt, you can able to write a simple statements, not about a complex logic, not about the big applications. Okay. So how many types of IDEs are used for this Python? Next, which is the runtime environment for Python? So for the Python, the runtime environment for the Python is the Python itself. The name runtime environment of the Python also named Python itself. So which IDEs we are using? Number of IDEs are there. Visual Studio Code, VS Code, PyCharm. Next, Anaconda. So like this, you can able to use Eclipse, Jupyter. Number of IDEs are there. Okay, so any IDE you can able to use it. Even Notepad++ also you can able to use. But you want to see the application in detail with the architecture, right? With the folder structure, right? So Notepad++ is not sufficient. So that's why let us go for the rich IDE. But these IDEs are the free. We don't need to purchase anything. No license is required. Okay. So mostly the look and feel wise, all IDs are same. For example, you may have the question, sir, if I use the VS Code and PyCharm, can I feel the difference? No. So that is nothing but it. So here you are able to see my Word document. I'm going to type something. That is also something simple, an editor. That's it. But these editors contains running the application options, debugging the application options, those things. Okay. Next. So how to check the Python is installed or not? Open the command prompt. Type Python. So it will be open like this. If you're able to type Python, it will open like this. So what is the version of Python? So the latest version is 3.10.7. Okay. Which version can I install? Better to install the latest version because I'm explaining this version. So any version that can be fine, it should be 3.7 plus, 3.8 plus, 3.7 almost it was introduced in 2018. Okay. Next. So how many versions of Pythons are there? I mean, major versions. Now this question for everyone. How many major versions of Pythons are there?
Three versions there.
Yes, what are those?
Last one we have it 3.7, then we had 3, and then we had 1.
So the major versions are 1, 2, and 3. Okay, 3.1, 3.2, like this, we're having the few other subversions. Okay, so do you have the compatibility from the Python 2.0 to 3.0? Team? For example, I'm having the, for example, you are developing the application using 3.0. Can I run this with the Python 2.0? Not possible.
Not possible. Okay.
In general, other programming language other than the Python, it is possible. In other programming language, it is possible. And it's not about a possible, they will give you the backwards compatibility. Okay, for example, you are using a WhatsApp. Okay, they are going to introduce a feature, but they are not going to eliminate a few earlier feature, right? So here, but coming to the Python, what they are doing, right? They are improvising the Python. Okay, so in this Python, they are come up with a new syntactical changes. These will not support in the older version. Remember that point. Yesterday we have noted. Okay, so if anybody missed, please go through the yesterday session. Okay, next. So see here, once you type the Python, it will show three arrows. So nothing but this is running your Python. Okay, Python. Sir, where is my Python? Here three things are there: Python framework, Python runtime environment, and IDE. Can I show? Yes. Okay, so initially let me go to the slow 1 or 2 week, 1 week to understand everyone. Okay, so all the installed software will be shown here. So see here, Python. So Python software is there. Hope you clear, right? Where is my Python framework? So there is a best advantage using the Python. For example, who developed the Python? Can we see what he developed the code? Yes, I will showcase that one also. Understand this point. Compared to other programming language, you can't able to see the inbuilt implementation for any syntax. But in the Python, we can see. So that's why I will show entire thing. Okay, here I'm having a software. Okay, now good, I was clear. Hope clear, right? Next, where is this runtime environment? Simply type Python. See here, Python 3.10, 64-bit, this is my runtime environment. Yesterday, we installed this runtime environment, if you remember. Yes or no? Yesterday, we install or no? Okay, so yesterday, we install three things. So here, the setup for Python. Next, here, see the runtime environment. Next, we install the IDE. Okay. What happen if I don't have this one? I will tell you. Okay, so understand the subject from end to end. The subject is very easy, but everyone is struggling while writing the different cases and the logic. Here I can able to help you for the end to end. Okay, just give your 2 to 2.5 months time and complete everyday labs. So Monday onwards I will give the daily labs. Okay, so if possible, complete the same lab. I know most of the members are working employed. So at the end of the week, try to be complete. Okay. So somebody here, they want to use this Python for the testing. Yes, I will help you for that one. Okay. Understand this core Python part. Somebody wants to learn the application. Yes, web application. This scenario series will be deals about the application development. Next one is the data science and artificial intelligence. Okay, end of the session, we will create 2 to 3 sessions, we'll discuss. Okay, so yesterday I have seen one video of the person in Hyderabad. He is studying the 8th class. Okay, so he just sitting in front of, I just met him, in front of the computer and drawing the paint. Where he drawing? In the air, just opposite. But whatever he is drawing in the air, he is showing in the computer. Okay. So that is called artificial intelligence. Simply giving the commands in the area you are going to be working. Okay. So this Python is the language. The 2022 onwards, the world is changing. Already Tesla is coming to the market. From then, everybody is changing. So Alexa, these people are once coming to the market. Nowadays, the Python was the two different one. Okay. So let us back to the course. So how I need to write a code? If you want to write a code, in yesterday's session, we created a folder Python programs. So let me remove. Okay, I will explain that one again. I have removed. So now it is the empty folder. Okay, so let me create a one folder. Hello. I'm just creating a one program. Okay. Something hello program. So did I have the any Python? Nothing. I just created a folder. Okay. So if you want to take these points as a running notes, how to create a Python program, simply create a folder first. Next, open Visual Studio Code. Open Visual Studio Code. So this is the one everybody is known. Now I'm giving you one command to open. See here. So how to open a Visual Studio Code? So go to the address bar, type CMD. Because if I open from here, tech guy and non-tech guy, everyone able to open. So we'll show the some difference, right? Yes. Simply type code space dot. It will open Visual Studio Code with that folder. So what is the command? Open VS Code from command prompt. So what you need to do, go to the address bar of the folder. Where? Please don't go anywhere. First, you need to go here only. Wherever you are having. So I want to go here in this folder because I want to work with this folder. Okay. Next, type CMD. What is the command? Code space dot press enter. Okay. Code space dot press enter. It will open Visual Studio Code. You want to see? See, hello. This is your folder name. Hope everybody is clear up to here. Any questions? Now I need to create or work with Python. Okay, so now the question for everyone, what is the extension of Python files?
.py.
Okay, .py is the extension. So simply create a new file. Okay, something first program or hello, whatever you want. Hello.py. If I say .py, then only the system can understand it is the Python. For example, let me create HTML page. index.html. Okay, so now this is the HTML page. But if you observe in the IDE, please observe here. So it is the clean. Okay, do you have any runner? No. So let me go to the hello.py. See here. If I use such a nice IDE here, you are having the runner. Okay, so automatically you can able to see the runner. Okay, so let me print some name. So where do we print? So as of now, you are using the Python. If you're using the Python or C sharp or Java, you can't able to show the output. Okay, until you are using the web framework. So we need to use the web framework. I will show you. So tomorrow session, I will show how to show a chart box within a 10 minutes. I will create a chart box in a 10 minutes. But not interactive chat box, but please wait and come for the tomorrow session without any missing chatbot. People are saying different advertisement, how to create a chatbot. It is very simple, 5 to 10 minutes. That's it. I will create and show you. Okay. See here, hello.py. So now I want to show the output. I want to print it, or else let me print some addition operation, 1 plus 2. So we're expecting 3. See here, runtime. So you're getting the output? Yes. Okay. Now you are clear. Let me drive to one more thing. So what are the three things? Once you are writing any program, three things will be involved. The first one is the Python, the framework to write your code. It will be provided some syntaxes. Yes, you are able to see the syntaxes print. So Python will be provided. Next IDE to write the code. Next runtime environment running the code. Yes or no? But here you are thinking, where is my runtime environment? Visual Studio Code is running, right? Am I correct or no? Where is my runtime environment? See. So this is my Python, right? Let me uninstall. Now I'm uninstalling this runtime environment. So try to be uninstall. I think it will take again 5 to 10 minutes. Let me avoid that one. Try to be uninstall and click on this one. So then it will be asked for, please install the runtime environment. Clear? So it will ask for your, please install the runtime environment. Okay, simply uninstall it. Okay, are you clear, right? Next, just uninstall, then it will be asked. So once you click on this one, if you observe, see here in the C, where is my Python, wherever is my Python, so that exe is going to be executed, runtime environment is going to be executed. So uninstall all your Python and try to be run it. You can't able to run it. Okay. Next. But a Python programming language is there, how it is developed. So if you want to develop any product, for example, you want to develop a car. Okay. So you want to refer something, right? Some products, right? Yes or no? So Python is also a one of the product, how the Python was developed. So to develop this Python, which programming languages they considered? Anybody? So ultimately, if you take this question, any programming, Java, C Sharp, .NET, PHP, you can able to answer, one answer is the C language. C is the father of all the programming languages, because by seeing the C only, they're developed. But C is the father, do we have the father of the C also? Yes, ABC. Earlier one is the ABC. But that much of in-depth, we don't need to worry. So take a heading. Python adapted the features from, so I will give you them from where it was adapted. The first one is directly C. C will be give what? A programming, so functional programming from C. Okay, so that's why while we're studying also the first C will be introduced. Do you know nowadays C is not a base language? So if you take a 5 to 6 years back, so you must complete the C in the earlier sessions. The higher sessions you are having a different. For example, if you are studying the bachelor, first year we are going to have the C. Now where is Python itself introducing for the kids? Do you know? Kids are implementing the rich applications. We are getting the shock. Okay. But what happened, right? We are in the work environment. We are little busy with our work. Otherwise, we also can able to implement it. Okay. Next, Python using the functional programming is C. Yes. But the C language using the OOPS concepts. So now the question I'm asking, C contain the OOPS concepts or no? Yes, let us make interactive sessions, everyone. So if you want to talk it, just unmute yourself. So C having the OOPS concepts or no? No. But which programming language having the OOPS? After the C, we are having the C++, nothing but CPP. Okay, CPP. CPP, which having the OOPS. Okay, after the C, we're having the, so Python adapted the features of object-oriented programming from the C++. Next, so oops is enough. Function is, do you have any other things? Yes, definitely. So we require the modeling feature and scripting features also. Without the script, can I implement a program? No. Without the script, you can't able to write automation test cases. Without the script, you can't able to implement a web application. Okay, so that's why it is having the scripting features also. Scripting language features from Perl and Shell. Perl and Shell. But so these are the information. If you remember not, that can be fine. It is good to know it. So from where it is there. If you know the C programming language, all the functionalities came here, but only syntax difference. If you're using the JavaScript also, it is contained the some scripting features, some functional programming. So arrays, collections, functions, all this from the C only. Okay, conditional statements. Okay, if you take any programming language, the functionality is the same, which is taken from the C only. Oops concept taken from the C++, most of the cases. Okay. But why we are using going for the different means, there is a reason. For example, if you want to go with the Java platform, I need to learn the Java, the syntactical variations. Each programming language should have a syntactic variation. For example, you are having the some two cars, car A and car B. Both are having the same features. If I give the price for one is the so-and-so 10 lakhs, one is the 8 lakhs. Which one you will buy? 8 lakhs, because I'll have the same features. So here also, here Microsoft having the different. So they are giving the inbuilt features. It is the paid version. Sun Microsystem giving the Java. Okay, it is the free version. So our Python is the free plus open source. I will show you the difference. Okay, next and last one is the modular programming features. From modular three, but don't worry about, for example, sir, you may have the question. If I want to learn this Python, did I have to go through all these things? Nothing. Okay, just a simply follow. So with this completion of these 2 to 2.5 months, you are going to get at least 2 years of hands-on experience, but practice is required. Okay, just a listening session is not enough. Practice is required. Okay, hope you clear, right? Okay, how the Python features are adapted. So now we'll go one by one. We'll see the simple Python coding, next OOPS concepts, next Django with the Python scripting, everything will go step by step. Any questions up to here? Okay.
No, sir. Okay.
So we're having the number of programming languages, why we are using the Python. So nowadays the companies are choosing the Python. So now there is artificial intelligence only will work, the 90% AI applications are using the Python. Scientific applications are using the Python. Why? Even a scientists are learning the Python and using there. But why they are not learning the .NET Java, I will show you. Okay, now itself we are going to be see it. So take a heading. Python benefits. So what are the benefits with Python? The first one is the Python is very simple English. So everyone able to understand. Okay, even scientists, whatever, tech guys or non-tech guys. Next, easy to learn. Simple English syntax, can you show me? So how are non-tech guys? Yes, I will show you. For example, hope yesterday's session, I have told you about complex numbers. Okay, hope you remember, right? So in the intermediate 10th class itself, we are having a complex number. See here, these are the complex numbers. 5 plus I root 3 something. Okay, see. So how to create, if you take a pen and a paper to write some complex simple example, how you are writing? A is equal to 1 plus 2j. Next, B is equal to 3 plus 2j. The scientist will be write like this. So did he have any programming skills? Nothing. He able to understand simple basic of the Python. That's it. Okay. So I just assigned data to A, data to B, and printing. Okay. Let me run. So 1 plus 3, 4, 2 plus 2, 4. 4 plus 4j. Clear? So that's why it is the very simple. They're using the simple and plain English. Okay. So everyone able to understand easily. Okay. Next one is the less coding. Are you feeling heavy coding now? No, nothing. Very less coding. More efficient, less coding, more efficient. So next and important one is the open source and the free. What is the difference between here? Here you are having the difference. See, open source versus free. Okay. So free means, can I use the Visual Studio code? Yes, it is the free. Okay. So .NET Core framework is the free and open source. Okay. So Java is the free version. Oracle is the free. What does that mean by open source? Free means without purchasing, you can able to download and use it. For example, you are using the CSS there, and on the top of the CSS, if you are using a Bootstrap, Twitter Bootstrap, it is a free version, but it is the open source. No, free means no payment. But if I use the .NET developer version is the free, but companies has to pay. If I use the Python, companies no need to pay even single rupee. What is mean by open source? See here. So here I'm having a print, right? Print, right? Right click, go to definition, team observe. Right click, go to definition. See, are you able to see the definition of this one? So let me click on again, right click, go to definition. Are you able to see? Yes. What are the techniques they are implementing? How they are writing everything we can able to see. We can able to see the how the syntax was implemented. So open source is nothing but we can able to explore the syntaxes. We can able to explore the coding of that syntax. We can able to see the how they're developed, how they implemented. So let me write one more thing. So int, int. Okay, int, int. So simply right click, go to definition. So it is going to definition. Yes, see the implementation. If you want to modify, you can able to modify. But your modification is only for this specific project, remember. So currently I'm using the Hello project, not specific project. Okay, but don't be play with this one. But now by this moment, in the future, we can able to modify. Okay. We can able to modify the framework also. That is the benefit with Python. Okay. So Python is nothing but it is the open product they are giving to you. However, you want to give the instructions, you can able to implement. Okay. Nothing but customized. Once you want to purchase the car, you are go and visit, they will sell, they will tell what type of color you want. We will customize. So you can able to customize the Python. So entire programming languages, so Python is only one programming language you can able to modify as per your requirement. So now you are having a question. Sir, my organization using the Python, we modify, but what about the inbuilt features? Inbuilt feature will be modified because you modify, na? But I'm having the clue two clients. One is the US client, the next one is the UK client. Same application, I want to give with a different feature. At that time, listen this point. My company architect, we're having the architect to team leader, senior team lead, manager, different categories, na? Wants to modify, he given the suggestion. Yes, you can able to modify. We'll see that modification in the upcoming sessions. Once you modify, can I give the same type of application to a UK client? But the UK client don't want this feature. So that's why we're having the virtual environment, VM, virtual environment. So this virtual environment is the concept only for the Python. Anybody heard about this virtual environment? Maybe you already working on this Python and virtual environment. Now you are clear. So who is working already on the Python? So I know everyone personally. So you just unmute yourself and answer. That's it. Okay. So in the while you are watching, you are saying about virtual environment will come up. So in this virtual environment, you can able to decide the versions and everything. Okay. So now hope you are clear, right? So Python is the open source and free. Open source means take this is the one. If free means no purchase. Without purchase, we can use it. Open source means we can explore the inbuilt coding of a feature or some syntax. Predefined syntaxes. Are you clear? So people may ask, sir, what is open source and but some programming languages are open source, but they are not allowing you to be modified. But Python is allowing you to modify. Few are allowing us to modify. Next, if you're using the C programming language, that is the platform dependent. But whatever our Python, platform independent. Platform independent. So next and important is our Python is dynamically typed programming language. So what is mean by dynamically typed programming language? That is the next one I will show you. Okay. So this Python is the extendable. So what is mean by extendable means? So just now I shown you are having the Python. For example, I'm having the feature of the int. Can I extend this one further? Yes, you can able to modify. You can able to modify. So this can be easily embedded. So because of this nature of embedded, so but it is not embedded system, it is the embedded. So hope Vijayendra yesterday asked the question, right? So how to use this Python? We are using the Python in our embedded system also. Hope you are from the embedded systems. Because the nature of the Python itself, you can able to embed it. Okay, so that's why we are using the Python in the many places. Okay, embedded systems where you can able to control. For example, you are having the cameras. So nowadays, everyone able to see the cams, right? So how to identify a person? Even Tesla also, how the Tesla is going to identify an object? Simply, if the Tesla using the Python for that one, Python having the mechanism to identify an object. How it is? So Python can't able to identify. See, for example, Python can't able to identify. So this is a Python, I mean, take it as a simple my car. Okay, so I'm going to driving. Okay, so please don't worry. So I'm going to be driving. See here I'm having an object. How it is identified? So here you are having the cams, infrared rays, LRDS, light. What is mean by LRDS? Vijayendra, maybe you can able to explain to everyone. Able to hear me? Maybe you are in the mute. So LRDS is nothing but a. So LED is nothing but a light emitting diode. LRDS is nothing but a. So they will be emit the light. So an object is opposite, it will reflect back. Once it is reflect back, then this information will be hand over to the chip. So we can able to easily embedded this Python anywhere, means we can able to write the program inside of the chip. See, here it is the chip. So in the chip, you are getting some signal. There our Python program is there. So the next topic of the Python is nothing but a data types. We are having the inbuilt data type to take the chip information also. Yes, it is possible only in the Python. Other programming language, it is not possible. We can able to take that information. Once if you take the information, very easily to take the decision or no. Can I move forward or can I move backward or can I stop? Now tell me, sir, no. Now tell me, yes or no? Sai, Vinay, Satvika, Shashi, Vamsi, Vijendra, Nitin.
Yes, Rasa. Sir.
So everybody is in the full concentrated mode. So two times we can't able to answer. One is the fully concentrated mode. One is the not understood one. Hope you are following. Any questions?
No, sir.
No.
Okay, fine. Hope you are fully following. Simply, if you develop such a big application, so see, this is the future. How much amount you are able to spend? Lakhs, nothing. Simply hundreds. You can able to write a program. But you are the program, you can able to spend this LRD diode will be take almost to 10 below 10 rupees, I think, but I don't know exactly. Let us take a below 100 rupees. Okay, so if you are the programming language, just you can able to spend here, you need to purchase a chip. Okay, so the chip wise, what type of chips are there? Vijendra, if you are in unmute, able to, you can able to tell us. So when I was studying IC, I was not remembering that chip. The name is a little different because number of companies are there to develop. I think chip is nowadays, I don't know, earlier it is a 5,000 or 6,000. Maybe it is the 10,000. Almost below 20,000, you can able to develop a such application, such a small application. Okay. Hope you are clear, right? Because all these are from the Python. Okay, so we are having a few other things also. Number of things also. Okay, we'll see. So So next one is the, so let us see how to write a comments, how to implement a comment in a Python. So how to implement a comments? So comments are two types. So now we have completed just introduction and base background of our Python. Now we are into the statements of the Python. How many statements are there? Statement first one is the comments. Next one is the data types. Let us go one by one. So we have the two types of comments. What are those? Any programming language, two types. One is the inline. Second one is the multi-line or block level. Multi-line comments are block level comments. Okay, we'll see how to work with this multi-line and block level. So simply here I want to write a comment hash complex numbers declaration. I write in the comment. So now I want to write the comment. Yeah, complex numbers and print data. So why we need to use the comments? So in the real time, so you are not going to work with the entire application, right? You are not going to work for the entire application. So that's why you need to write a comments, but the comment will be give the definition. Tomorrow we need to work for the 10 to 20 lines of the program. So at that time, number of things we are going to write it. Okay, so these comments will be tell about the program. So comments give info about the function or whatever you written the program. Okay, so inline means hash. So multi-level or block level, multi-line or block level, how to write? Anyone? Three ticks. These are the singular double ticks. For example, I want to comment. See, here I can able to write comments. Okay, can I write? So what is a single tick and double tick? We'll tell you, but not this moment. So here you can able to write a number of comments. Okay, clear. So next, the important foremost one is everyone please be concentrate data types. So I will introduce you about this data type and close the today's session. We'll continue data types tomorrow. So what are these data types? So what is the purpose? For example, I want to book a flight. Let me do some shopping. Okay. When is something festival is came on? Something mobile I click. See, now I will show you the data types. See, I'm showing the practical Amazon website. So by this moment, you don't know how to open, how to inspect. See here. Here I'm clicking on the right click inspect page, or else I'm just pressing the F12. But all these things going further we'll discuss. Okay, in upcoming sessions we're going to be discuss. Don't worry if you don't know. Okay, let me go to the network tab. Clear. So let me add to the add cart. Add it. Cart. Subtotal added to the cart. So now let me see. We can able to see But here they will, instead of us to understand everything, they will be write some different names. So yeah, maybe they given some name. So let us leave it. Let me leave that one. So see here, a request. See, I think this is the adding the cart. What is my request? I'm just requesting to add a cell phone, right? Are you able to see? Request. MID, RID. Something MID, RID means they given some names. Who given? Amazon, developer given SID, SN. Okay. But here our intention is, so once I click on a cart, it is able to adding the cart. How it is possible? For example, you want to transfer or else you want to post some letter to me, some greeting to me. So how you are going to be sent? Using the post. You are going to your nearby post. You want to send some product to me. Okay. Some product to me. Okay. So end of the sessions, so you got settled well, you learn very well, you got a very good job, you want to send us sweets. How we are going to send us sweets? Through a post. Or else through a transport. So this transport means they are going to carry forward the information. They will take that sweet box and they deliver. So here also, in case of applications, so who is the carriers? Without the carriers, nothing is there. For example, you are texting a hi in a WhatsApp. You are just typing a hi in a WhatsApp, click on a send. How I'm receiving the data? Hi. For example, you are sending some amount to me. How I am receiving? A carriers are required or no? Okay. So in the programming language, these data types are the carrier. See, these are the variable names. So what type of the data types? So what type of the data types you are not going to show inside of this tool. So what is this tool? Simply, you can able to open your web application. Click on inspect or press F12. Okay, go to this network tab. So once you're going to the network tab, after that one, click on that item. See here, who is the data carrier? These are the data carriers. So it is carrying the my requirement cell phone, and this cell contains the so and so data. So they are having the so and so information. They are not fully exposing the data, maybe security something. So now you are clear, right? So if you want to transfer the information, you require the postman. So our postman is nothing but a data types. Okay. So what is the definition of the data types? Data type will carry the data or information. Data type will carry the data or information. For example, in the automation testing, I want to perform a click action. If you want to perform a click action, you need to hold that variable name. So that will be held by the data type. So you can able to say data type will holds the data. You can able to give any definition. For example, I want to transfer a amount. So once I click on sponsor amount, what is the amount? Who is the sender? Who is the receiver? Address, everything you are going to fill in the application, right? Who will take care? Our data types. Okay. Hope you are clear, right? What is the data type?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Okay. So in the next session, I will explain about. So Python is following what type of the data types? In general, how many data types are there? Okay. So Python having the what type of the data types? So compared to the other programming language, Python has some specialties. Okay. So earlier you are having the phones. So the calling will be different. For example, the receiver you need to be put on your ear and the mouth you need to be put nearby your mouth. Yes or no? So nowadays inbuilt features. Nowadays, people are using watches. Watch. Which watch? Digital. Digital. So that watch will be calculate your BP, AP, CP, everything, right? So now the technology is changing. So when compared to other programming language, Python contains a rich set of data types. Because of these data types, I can able to use in the embedded. I can able to use in the artificial intelligence in different places. Okay. So what I have discussed today. So what I have discussed to team today. So today we have gone through the yesterday's introduction. Python adapted features from next benefits with Python. Next, how to create a simple Python program. Okay, so in upcoming sessions, daily we are going to see the real-time oriented scenarios, but these are the demonstration sessions. Okay, so and we need to know about some theory. Okay, for example, you want to travel somewhere, you want to open the Google Maps, but you know, right, what is the purpose of that place. Okay, this is the information. The traveling will start in 2 to 3 days. Traveling will start. Okay, data type intro. Okay, any questions? Okay team, that's it for today. Thanks for joining. Use the same link. We'll meet tomorrow.